Hey, happy Tuesday, everybody. Welcome to a Tuesday edition of 5 Minutes with Phil. Thank you for joining me here today. I want to, first of all, start off by saying if there is somebody that you care about that you think could be blessed by one of these 5 Minutes with Phil episodes, then by all means, let's get the word out, okay? How can you do that? Well, on YouTube, you can like, that's the little thumbs up. You can subscribe. You can actually ring the bell and you'll get a notification of when a new video drops to our Bethel Church account. And you could share the links with your friends. Also on Facebook, you can go to our Facebook page, which is nothing but 5 Minutes with Phil, and you can share those videos as well. Invite your friends to be a part of that page, and they will not miss an episode either. So if we can help somebody that you care about, then for us, that's a pretty huge win. So thanks for giving us the opportunity to do that. Now, let's unpack God's word for the day, okay? Yesterday, we talked about how the Lord was such a good listener of us and how he hears us at all times. Today, we take a look at what I would think our response would be to all that God does for us. And we're in Psalm chapter 66. So why don't you look at this verse with me and we're going to read it together. Psalm 66, verse 16, it says, "Come and listen, all you who fear God, and I will tell you what he did for me." Come and listen, all you who fear God, and I will tell you what he did for me. Now, what's really great here is the fact that the psalmist, I think, reminds us in this verse that there's a couple of groups that we can share what God's done with. And the first one is to each other. Come listen to those who fear God. I'll tell you everything that God's done for me. I think there is a lot of power in sharing a testimony of how good God has been to you and how he's answered your prayer, how he's come through for you, how he has helped you, how he has been there for you through so much. There's a lot to be said about sharing the goodness of God with other people, because you know what that is. We're not trying to make people feel bad because you got blessed and they didn't. That's silly. And if anybody takes it that way, they've got some growing up to do. What this really is, it's our saying, okay, this is what God's done for me. And you know what that does? That strengthens our faith. That strengthens their faith. There is power in testimony. There is power in sharing your testimony with other people. And your testimony is not just how you got saved. Your testimony is about what God's done for you. If he answered a prayer for you, tell somebody. If he came through for you, tell somebody. If you got blessed unexpectedly, tell somebody. Somebody needs to hear that so that they can know that, hey, if God did it for you, he'll do it for them. And let's not forget to share the goodness of God with people that may not know Jesus yet. Because what I love about a testimony is that people can see what God's done in your life and they can begin to put their faith in God because they see how Jesus is moving in your life. Your testimony can actually have a significant impact on the spiritual journey of somebody who doesn't even know Christ. And so, you know what? If God's done something for you, I really want to encourage you today. Tell somebody. Tell a fellow believer. Tell somebody who doesn't know Christ yet. And God can only bless when that kind of thing happens. Okay? All right. Thanks for joining me. We love you. I hope you have a great day. We'll talk to you again later. Bye-bye.